We're going to move to our keynote session by Mr. Anuj Jain, Executive Director, Nerolac Paints. Welcoming our keynote speaker, Mr. Anuj Jain, Executive Director, Nerolac Paints, who started his career at Kansai Nerolac Paints Limited in the year 1990 as management trainee. From 1990 to 1999, he worked in the sales function department and covered various markets in the north and south regions of India extensively. Thereafter, he shifted to Mumbai and was recognized for his noteworthy contribution and expertise in marketing. Mr. Anuj Jain has a career spanning over 30 years at Kansai Nerolac. He took over as the Vice President, Marketing and Sales in April 2003. Thereafter, he was promoted to the designation of Director, Decorative for Kansai Nerolac Paints in 2010. And from 2018, he is serving as the Executive Director in charge of entire sales and marketing, manufacturing, and technical. In his current capacity, Mr. Jain is responsible for driving growth organically and inorganically, along with business excellence. He will be here talking on building a dynamic future. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Mr. Jain on screen.
Thank you, Khyati. I'm very happy to be here. My best wishes to Dentsu and E4M Digital for this launching this fifth edition advertising report. The theme here is driving business outcomes in digital-first world. I'm happy to share my views, turn off my video, and share the presentation. So evolve. Now, just to make a start, I would like to say that, technology is really speeding up the process of human evolution. And it is very important for a business to keep up with this digital change evolution so that we can build promising future for the business, for the consumers. The pace of technology change is so fast that either the businesses or brands are doing well or falling short.
In India,
In India,
as of today,
70 crore people have access to the internet. And in next 5 years' time, it is expected that this number will cross 100 crores. I think the brands have to be ready to a digital-only consumer. It is really becoming a social currency. The digital adoption is must for any age group. If it is not, then somewhere the social connect start going. This fast change is creating an environment. And today, when we look at that, so much of digital transactions are happening, and we call it transactions, because in the old days, we used to build relations with the customer. And if today technology or the digital has to replace the human touch, I think what is important to understand that in those days, you or we were contacting our customers at the different stage what their needs are, at what time they need to list what. So, because today with transaction, where that transactions are online. Dimensional and complex, to say the least. So, I would use one example here from paint industry that to delight the consumer, what we need to do. Now, if you look at paint, and I'm sure all of you must have experienced, it follow a consumer journey. At the start, you decide about when you think of doing a paint, then you say, let's see. And at that stage, you have some requirement that what budget, how much it is going to cost, consultation with the family. Then you shift to the next stage, dream, because you start visualizing that when I do a painting, how my walls are going to transform, how my home is going to transform. And you start dreaming that, the color choice. And then you get into the process of let's know what kind of product, what kind of features, what we need to compromise, what we need to optimize. And then you shift to the next stage of concluding, let's lock. You are making the final choice that which product, what functional features, what kind of shades. You are making the final choice. And then you proceed with that. Let's go, where the actual painting process is happening. And once the painting process is complete, then is a time where you are able to see what kind of turnaround, transformation, has happened in your home space. So that's a complete journey. And in this journey, consumer want to be very focused at every stage. He does not want to get bombarded with all the information. I think at every stage, there's a requirement of intervention, and that is the kind of empowerment what consumer want to have in his hand. And therefore, in this slide, I'm talking about that how can businesses focus on empowering through engagement. And for this, I think we need to privacy, transparency. That's very important. So it's a testament of the businesses need to be of sharing such as writing techniques, organization culture on a regular basis. And I think last but not the least, it need to be inclusive and sensitive of the environment they collaborate with, cultures, geographies, languages, and people at large. So these are very important principles to follow. So from this, we can clearly say that the gears are really shifting, the change is really happening, and new technologies. At Narolec, we have seen the impact of artificial intelligence on improving our sales operations through aspects like visit plan, sales forecast, geotagging, heat maps, chatbots, you know, a different kind of thing. Today, you know, we have a large sales force in the market, and each person has the tab with him where he's able to understand for a customer. We deal with large number of customers, that what is his buying pattern, what is his behavior, what he's going to take, in what kind of period, or, you know, some solution is provided to them. A new business, the power of AI, you know, they have revolutionized the world of stock breaking. It's a real good change. Artificial intelligence in the world of marketing, where we say today in the mass media, when you show the ad, you know, it's visible to all, even if people don't want to see it, and sometimes it becomes irritating for them. But this is the technology which can at least present the ads to be seen by those who really want to see it, who really respect it. That's the power of artificial intelligence. The second change here, or the emerging technology, is augmented and virtual reality. You know, we used to say in the world of digital, the imagination and the reality. I think with this augmented, we can do that. Just giving you an example here, we have introduced one Color My Space app. So basically, you know, customer who want to see that how my room to look like after the paint, he can just, you know, take a picture of his room. He can pick up, you know, the from the shades are available. He can pick up some inspirational decor ideas and can place them on their, you know, on their wall and see that how it will look like. And that's, you know, real great. That I'm able to augment, I'm able to see that post painting, how it is, you know, going to be different. And I think this is related to, you know, if you want people to work on the machine, you know, today you can provide the training on the machine, real machine, but then through the augmented and virtual reality, you know, this can be done. VR is very effective for the training. The people working on the field, people working in the factory, different machine, how we use the virtual reality to see that our physical efforts, you know, are reduced, and we are able to use more on more and more brain. And these, you know, applications are available in the various languages. I was giving example of Narolec Color My Space. It is available in 10 different languages. So even language is not the, you know, barrier. From this technology, I come to the second part, which is the content. And that's also a very important part. And the content is not all about, everybody knows that, you know, more contents, more relevant contents you have, more you are able to come closer to the consumer. But I think here what we are talking about is, it's not only the content, but as a brand owner you need to create, but also the content which you are getting created through the consumer feedback, the response, sharing, what he's talking about your you know, product or about the brand and what he's sharing in a circle. So that's also an important part of the content. Giving a very good example here is Home Depot. They took the game of content to a different level with the Shop the Look collaboration with Pinterest. Through the VR feature on image collecting app, they made the game of inspirations easy, and today Instagram is pioneering the business with shopping ads. It's a great example of how consumers are generating love for a brand through shares and comments and pins. So if you look at this example or the earlier examples that I've used, you can clearly say that how this space is evolving and emerging, and therefore businesses need to shape up for the future. They have to make, by adopting digital evolution, they have to make the business future proof. Because today is different from today. The future is digital transformation. The cost involved is huge, but it is important for business to know the trends they need to follow and do not fall into the fads. Gone are the days when campaigns were developed on pure gut, intuition, you know, understanding. But I think today it needs to be more informative. And it's not only merely an information, I think it's a deep insight which you can get on this particular platform. All of us, the brand people, need to learn social listening skills. Otherwise, there's a possibility of losing the deep insights. There are a lot of examples in the current times, like Swiggy, Netflix. They're changing the dials of social listening and building brand value with each comment. Businesses are using a lot of analyzing tools to discover what their target audience is, because this platform is available. The people are sharing, people are commenting. The business is, how do you understand your customers better so that you are able to intervene, you are able to, you know, attend your customers on this platform rightly and at right time. Consumer sensing is taking the center stage. And I think it's important to say that, you know, here, that consumer sensing is the new consumer understanding. By listening, you're able to understand at what stage, what consumer is wanting, what consumer is sensing, taking the insights from there, and then, you know, we have opportunity to build proposition based on these insights and these understanding. The next important part is that we have spoken about emerging technologies, some of the trends, but I think it is equally important to acknowledge the talent that is at the back end of all this. With technologies accelerating, the need for skilled talent is also at an all-time high. Businesses should not shy away from training their in-house talent continuously, regularly, as business goals now and in the future. Skill to scale is the right way to go. So upskilling and nurturing continuously the talent is very, very important. So I think with this, I'm coming towards the end of this presentation, where I would say that digital is important, digital is evolving, and digital is important. It's affordable, it's digital can optimize, digital can integrate. Simple examples today, where, you know, we create one email and then it leads to a lot of automations. For example, we'll hear songs on the Spotify. So I can always ask Alexa, hey Alexa, I want to hear my favorite songs. And Alexa can pick up the song from the favorites of my favorites on the Spotify. So that's the kind of integration, and it can lead to a lot of things, you know, integration with the lighting, songs, and so many other things. So I think if we miss that digital initiatives, we miss these particular changes, we don't know that what next change we are going to miss. So if we do not want to miss the future, it is important to adopt the digital changes, the digital evolution. And that's why I would like to end my presentation by saying that let's embrace digital evolution. It is important for all the businesses, the small businesses who are not able to create their brands earlier. Now there's opportunity available. People can work in a very, very focused manner by embracing the digital changes and can get the answer to their questions, to their problems, and the right solution. With the right solution, the businesses can be future-proof and the relationship with the consumers can be built. Thank you so much. And I look forward for the session, the case studies during the day, and my best wishes to all the participants. Thank you. Thank you, Khyati.
Thank you so much, Mr. Jain.